Master K, what's happening? What's happening? Happy Wednesday. Won't he do it? Yes, he will. Hey, Darren, what's up, man? Good to see you, brother. Mother Denise, hello. Welcome. Won't he do it? Said he would. Hey, fight your battles for you, y'all. Yes, he will. Cheryl, it's Sherry Alexander in the house. Welcome. Welcome, everybody. Hey, can he do it? He said he would. All right. Won't he do it? And yes, he will. Be so amazed because of his grace, y'all. Woo! All right. Gotta trust him at all times. Yes, sir. Won't he do it? Yes, he will. All right. How is everybody doing? God bless you. Welcome, 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 everybody. Welcome to Midweek Service with Lakeland Christian Center. My name is Pastor Derek Griffin, and once again, it is a plum pleasing pleasure for me to be here this evening with you all. And thank you so much for joining us. I think it's just an honor that you all take the time to come in and join us on every Wednesday at 7 o'clock to hear the word of God. And it is just a true honor to be able to deliver this message on these days. I thank Pastor Riley and Pastor Kay for allowing me to do this. I mean, to be able to sit here and bring you a word is really an honor. It's a pleasure as well. I enjoy doing it. And I thank God that he has blessed me to be able to deliver word, his word to his people. I just wanted to say a couple of things. Happy birthday to Evangelist Antoinette, if she's on board. How you doing? Happy birthday. And then also congratulations to all of those who were elected on yesterday into their leadership positions. The mayor, Mayor Dickens, Andre, congratulations. And I did hear, oh, and also we have a new mayor in South Fulton. My son, his name slips my mind, but congratulations to him, Khalil. Congratulations to him for his victory as well. And then I overheard a little birdie said that, guess what? Guess who's running for governor? Wow. Stacey Abrams has announced she's running for governor, y'all. Isn't that awesome? Whoo! I tell you, it's time to get busy, guys. It's time to get ready. God is for real. God is alive. God is well. And ain't nothing wrong with him. But we got to get ourselves together. Get it right. Get it right. So I'm going to go ahead and pray and get started. And also take notes. Those of you who are actually studying to become a minister, hi, Mother Betty, with us, please take notes as Pastor Riley will be checking in on you to make sure that you're in tune and you're ready to go to become a minister here at Lakeland. And those of you who are astute and love to learn, I advise you to take notes as well, because you know I'm coming hard. I'm coming with it. I'm coming in to make sure that you get God's word and his word only. Amen. All right. Let me pray. Father God, thank you so much for allowing me to minister tonight to these your sheep. Let me ask that you think through my mind and speak through my vocal cords as well, that the word will come and provide revelation knowledge to them so that no evil or satanic force will stop this word from coming forth, so that people can be edified and encouraged and uplifted and reminded of how powerful, God, you are in their lives. God, I thank you, and I want to pray for those right now who are sick and shut in, going through challenges in their health, going through healing in the hospitals, in their homes. They're facing challenges this holiday season. God, I pray that you send angels to minister to them. And I also pray a special healing from you, God, on their lives, a miraculous healing for them, that they will have the ability to walk away from all of those challenges that the enemy has placed upon them, in order to, that their faith may be increased in you. God, give them healing, my brother Moses. Give them healing, God. And all of those who I know right now, God, that I will not mention, but I will say you are a good God and you will take care of them. And I want to give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen, 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 amen. All right, Mother Moore, Mother Moore, Mother Moore, how you doing? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay. All right. I really like this message tonight, guys and ladies. It really blessed me when I got started on it. And believe it or not, as soon as I had gotten it done and put the stamp on it, the challenges immediately came in my life. And so it got real quick, because you got to understand, when you start touching on God's word and start, reading it and trying to digest it, that you have to know that it's a part of your life and that you have applied these things in your life, so that you have a genuine, sincere approach to delivering it to those whom you love. And God loves you. I love you. And I wanted to make sure that this was a very touching message that you will understand and receive in the right way. And God wanted to make sure that I did the same thing. And so I have been challenged in this area, and I thank God for allowing those challenges to come my way, to challenge my faith, to increase my faith in his word. Tonight's topic is God is on your side. God is on your side. Let's say this. Have you ever felt like you were alone? You were going through some tremendous challenges and you couldn't get other people to understand. You try to talk to this person, that person, even your pastor, and it just seems as if nobody gets it. And you're going through it, and you know that it's just tiresome, it's burdensome, it's wearing you out. I know you've been through that sometime in your life. You have all kinds of attacks, whether it be in your health, whether it be in your family, your children, your parents, your grandparents, your job, even in your love life. You know, you have issues with your spouses and you're challenged, you're battling not to divorce, you're battling trying to get away from all the struggles of being, being financially inept. You know, you don't have enough money to meet the bills, the challenges, you can't get the job. I mean, it's just overwhelming sometimes, the things that we go through, and it can be very lonely. And so in that loneliness, you feel like nobody cares. You really become overwhelmed and saddened. But I got a good message tonight. I've got some good news for you. God is on your side. Let's look at the foundational scripture. Let's go to Deuteronomy 20:4. I'm going to read the New International Version of this scripture translation, and it's Deuteronomy 20:4. It says this: "For the Lord your God is the one who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to give you victory." Let's look at that again. Let's just slow it down. I'm going to slow down tonight because I can get on skates and start flying through this message. I really want this to sink in, because it had to sink in my spirit through the challenges that I've been faced with this past 2 weeks. I mean, it's been amazing how things can turn around, and now you got to get real with God's word. But it says this once again. It says, "For the Lord your God is the one who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to give you victory." Let that sink in. See, dear friends, never forget that God is on your side. Yes, God is on my side. God is on your side. God is on our side. No matter what you're facing today, remind yourself of this truth. God is on my side. Somebody type that in there for me. God is on my side. I think you all need to really get that. Let that sink in. You've got the Almighty God himself. He's got your back. He's got your back. I'm going to prove it to you tonight with this word. See, Satan, the enemy, likes to attack us by telling us lies contrary to God's word. Thoughts of worry, doubt, and fear have the power to consume our minds, causing us to lose hope. When you begin to have these feelings, it can be hard to decipher God's truth from the enemy's lies. No matter what you're up against, God has your back, and he will never leave you. See, we got to understand that when things get hard, it's very easy to forget that God is there for us. It's like we have this bad habit that as soon as we get challenged, we start running to people. We start sharing our business with other people. You know, we get on the phone, we call auntie, or we call our best friend, or we call whomever we feel is going to listen to our issues. And do you know half the time they don't want to hear your mess? Do you know that most people, when you start calling, if you're the type of person that always calls with issues, that they really don't want to pick up the phone and talk to you? And I'm talking about well-meaning believers who run away from folks that have problems. They don't want to deal with your problems. You know why? Because they have problems of their own. And it's the most amazing thing that human nature, the flesh, it really keeps us from coming together and being there for each other because we have not understood this one simple fact that God is on our side. See, during hard times, it is a natural response to turn to family and friends for support and encouragement. Although having these relationships are important, God should always be the first person we turn to. No matter what type of help you need, the creator of the universe has all power, and there is nothing too hard for him. If you go to Jeremiah 32:17, I'm going to read the New International Version to show you what God says about his power. Watch this. It says, "Ah, sovereign Lord, you have made the heavens and the earth by your great power and outstretched arm. Nothing is too hard for you, Lord." Nothing. So that means even though we may look at a situation and it may seem impossible to deal with. I mean, I've dealt with some really stubborn people in my life that you just be, you're impossible. You know what I'm saying? You're just impossible. You'll never change. No matter how much you know the person that is wrong, they're still going to believe the lie. They're just going to stay in the lie. They're going to live the lie. They're going to talk the lie. They're going to make the lie the truth. And they ain't going to change. They're stubborn as an ox. But guess what? God can fix it. God can turn them around. God can come in and fix a situation that's unfixable in man's eyes. That's what we have on our side. That's who we have on our side, the fixer of all wrong. I mean, it's just a wonderful thought. If you let that sink in, brothers and sisters, that when God is in it, you're going to automatically win. When God is in it, we automatically are going to have victory over whatever the circumstance may be, no matter how hard it may seem to you. It's not hard for him. See, when it comes to fighting for you, other humans will fall short against the almighty power of God. If you rely on him, you will always win. I will repeat, if you rely on God, you will always win. As you surrender to him, he will fight for you. See, sometimes a lot of us are real bullheaded and we want to fight the fight. We want to get out there and start going against it and doing what we think we got to do to get it done and pull ourselves up by our own bootstraps and all this kind of stuff the world tells you to do. And, you know, there's some fights you just aren't built to win. I'm just going to be honest with you. And I'm going to be, here's another thing. God will put you in a test where you can't win on your own. It's going to be a test where you have to surrender to God and watch him do what he does. Let him fight that battle because he wants to. And that's something that we have to get a clue on. God wants to fight our battles. He's not like man that just sits there and says, "I'm not getting in the middle of this. Are you serious? That's your problem." That's what man says. "I don't want nothing to do with your domestic issue. Don't call me. Don't call me. I ain't got nothing for you." But God says, "Put me in the middle of it. Because I can shut everybody up." God ain't playing. He said, "I'll shut you all down," right? I mean, it's amazing what he'll do. Even with pandemic, he'll say, "Look, it looks like pandemic ain't going nowhere." About he said, if God wants to, he'll shut it down. Pandemic will have no, I mean, come on now. We've got to recognize that the Lord is on our side and he's all powerful And he wants to fight our battles. Please understand, God wants to do those things for you because he cares for you. Watch this. Our minds are a battlefield, okay? We know this. And where good thoughts and bad thoughts are constantly fighting for our attention. Now, we have to agree to that. We have to understand that most issues begin here. They start in our heart, in our mind, in our spirit. It begins in the heart, which is your mind, your subconscious, your mind. And then all of a sudden, you're just going through all of these negative thoughts that's wearing you out. And it's hard to find the truth of God's word to kind of take out those negative thoughts, to put you in back into a place of peace and confidence in him. And so God wants us to understand. That's why he says meditate on his word, because you need to have it inside of you to get ready to use it when you need it, because you're going to be bombarded with negative thoughts, negative issues, negative circumstances. They come. They ain't stopping. They're going to keep coming and knocking at your door. Sin is crouched at the door ready to jump on you. But as long as you're in Jesus, in Christ Jesus, come on now, as long as you know the word of God and you've got that word and you know how to use it right, you're going to be all right. See, it's up to you to filter through which thoughts you choose to entertain. See, some of us like to be negative. There's some people who have a propensity to be negative. Negative, 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 negative. Every time we talk to them, they got something negative to say. You need to get away from those folks, because they obviously don't have the truth of God in them or the light of Christ in them. Because see, when you have the light of Christ, there's a joy that emanates from people who walk in the Spirit. There's not always a humdrum, oh, woe is me mentality when you have the right relationship with God. Because you understand the truth that I'm sharing with you, that no matter how hard it gets, God's got it. God's got it. Some people like to entertain negativity. They want to hear negative stuff about what's going on in your family. They want to see that you're struggling with, you know, your life, and to make themselves feel better. See, that's that Negro stuff. I put it in a nice term. But you know where I'm going with that. You know what I'm saying? That Negro stuff. You know the other way. Come on now. Always trying to put somebody else down just so you can feel better. God said, I can fix that too. See, we got to be careful about running to people who only care about what's going on good in their lives. Right? They don't care anything about what's going on in yours. They're so selfish and so self-contained and prideful that they only care about what's going on with them, what they got, where they're going. And you try to go to them for help and you could forget about it. And that's where people get hurt. People are always disappointed by other folks, that they have these expectations that they're going to be there for them. And 9 times out of 10, they will not. And God has warned us about trusting in man like that. He said, don't you trust in that man. You're supposed to be trusting in God, because God said, trust him with all your heart. So if he has all your heart, why are we giving some of it to mankind? See, we serve God, right? First, so that God can empower us and give us his word, his strength, so we can be a blessing to man, because man needs us to bless them, not to worry them to death. Did you get that one? Man doesn't need us to worry them to death. God said, worry him. Give him your worries and he'll take care of you. I got a good word for you now. Now, that's why in the Bible, when he says, when you have these battle thoughts, thoughts of negative thoughts, positive thoughts going on, the Bible even says, for that reason, the Bible tells us to think on good things. Try to always think on good things. I know it can be hard. I've been there. It's like as soon as that negative thing comes, you're off track, and man, you're riding that thing for Lord knows how long, that negative thought. You're going to ride it. You're going to open it up. You're going to blow it up. You're going to exacerbate the situation. You're going to overthink the situation. And all of a sudden, you find yourself getting depressed and getting worn down and getting wore out and getting old, aging, getting gray. You know what I mean? You're going down, man. But let me tell you something. God said, it's on you. You didn't do what I asked you to do or told you to do in my word. Go to Philippians 4:8. Watch what he says. I'm going to read the New International Version. This is what it says. It says, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. It's like when Pastor Riley tries to get a positive word to us about how God has blessed Lake Gwen and how we're doing such a wonderful job with God's help in the community and bringing forth things that's blessing families and people who are disadvantaged. We bring advantages and we've been working well. The city loves us and the city comes to us and asks us to be there for them, to help them develop the city. That's a blessing. But you've got some negative folks that get an attitude and get sidetracked because they don't want that positive. They'd rather dwell on the negative and say, well, I ain't got nothing to do with that, and I ain't making no money from that. And that's not what God wants you. See, God is testing us. He wants to see, is your mind right? See, you got to get your mind right in order to get into a right situation with God, right standing with God, because it's your stinking thinking that's blocking your blessing. See, it's stinking thinking that's stuck on the negative that won't allow you to experience the positive that God has for you laid out on a buffet table. You can't even grab at it because you're blocking your blessing with your negative thoughts that you do not use the word of God to take out and bring in his word so you can experience the goodness of God. The goodness of God comes to those who think good things. Ooh. See, God is not about reverse psychology. He ain't about your pity party. Nope, not about your pity party. I used to think that. I used to do that. I'm guilty. Guilty as charged. I used to get into my little pity party and get to wailing and crying about why me, woe is me, thinking that's going to move God to do something better for me. Wrong. It just got worse. And so I had to figure it out. God said, you're going to figure this thing out one day, son. I ain't got time for your pity party. You better accept my goodness and receive it right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Golly. Y'all hear me? So let's go on. If you allow the cares of life to consume you, sadness and depression are soon to follow. You know what? They say this is the season, the holiday season, where a lot of people get into depression. It's quite common. A lot of us lose loved ones during this season. A lot of folks pass on and die during the holiday season. It's a strange cycle that you may recognize. And some of you all kind of dread the holidays coming because it brings back to memory the loss of your loved ones because they won't be there to share it with you. I had to share my first Thanksgiving without my mom. But I was full of joy because I know she's in the right place. She's with the Lord. And so it was exciting to be there with family and friends. I was not no way tired or no way depressed, just thankful. I mean, really thankful that I had a good mother. My mother was a good mother. And so I have her in my thoughts, in my heart, in my prayers, and she's always with me. I don't have a problem with it. But some people can't deal with loss. Some people get depressed. They get overwhelmed. They get overshadowed. But it's because of God's word I was able to deal with the loss and understand it. And God gave me his peace because I surrendered to him and I allowed him to come in and do that for me. Some folks don't do that. See, you can't allow the cares of life to consume you. You have to allow God's goodness to consume you. See, it's your choice. You either choose good or you choose bad. We're free moral agents. No one forces you to choose a negative thought. It's on you. It's up to you to either accept it or to kick its tail and say, go away. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Amen. So watch this. Did you know that anxiety in your heart has the power to weigh you down? Listen to me now. The power, anxiety in your heart has the power to weigh you down. Go to Proverbs 12 and 25. I'm going to read the NIV version again. Proverbs 12 and 25. It says, anxiety weighs down the heart, but a kind word cheers it up. Isn't that amazing? A kind word, a positive word can cheer a negative heart, a negative mind up. Let's start working on saying positive things to each other, especially those of us in the body of Christ. Let's stop being negative. Let's stop trying to put each other down and ridicule and condemn. That's not God's spirit. That's Satan's spirit. Satan wants to condemn us. Satan wants to judge us. Satan wants to make us get caught up in who said, she said, he said, when we should be doing what? What God said. See, it's so important that we learn this, but it only comes with practice. It comes when you really want a change in your life, when you put forth the effort. Because the Bible says the diligent gets the reward. He that diligently seeks him. That means that you're constantly looking for the positive in what God is telling us. You're not going to settle for the negative that the world is telling you. You're not going to settle for the depression that is overtaking you. You're not going to settle for the confusion that's overwhelming you. You're going to go to God's word. You're going to pull out all those scriptures that tells you how great he is in your life. And you're going to meditate on that until those negative feelings go away forever. Forever, never to return, because now you have the truth of God's word in your life. So therefore, it's comforting to know you have someone on your side rooting for you called God the Father. Whoo! He's rooting for us now. He wants us to win. The scriptures tells us that we can share all our cares and worries with God because he cares for us, right? Well, you can find that in 1 Peter 5 and 7. 1 Peter 5 and 7, the NIV version says, cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. So rather than allowing anxiety in your heart to weigh you down, God says, cast it up to him. Casting means to take it and give it away. Just give it away. I don't want it. You can have it. And God said, I'll take it. Because God says, it don't bother him. It doesn't bother him. It doesn't bother God for you to give him all of your worries. It doesn't bother. He wants them. Get your mind right and recognize he wants you to give him your concerns about your children, your concerns about your finances, your concerns about your ministry, your concerns about your spouse, your concerns about your health. Now, it doesn't mean that you're going to neglect the faith that's required for you to deal with that by faith, but it does mean you have to mentally cast those thoughts, negative thoughts, and give it to God and replace them with his truth and now operate on the truth in faith, knowing that you will be delivered from those situations, having a positive outlook on the outcome. That's what it's all about. You gotta have a positive, and even if you don't get there and die, you're still going to heaven. I mean, good God, you win. You got to stay focused on the positive outcome. It's going to be all right. No matter what they say about, what's that new variant called Omicron, I believe it is, the new COVID-19. Stop it. Just stop it. Let it do what it's going to do. If you're with God, you win. Omicron has nothing on us. Come on now. Let's not repeat the same old stupid behaviors we did when COVID-19 first hit. Some of us learned our lesson. Some of us even caught the disease and had victory and overcame it, praise God. So we know we have the victory in Christ. Omicron ain't got nothing on us. Let's not get ignorant and foolish and start operating in fear. And here it comes and I need to lock down and go back in my house and get afraid of people. Y'all know we're bold in Christ. No, stop it. Stop it. Don't let the world fool you. Stop it. See, that's what God says. That's when you know God can come in. That's what he wants. He wants to defeat those kind of enemies for us. He doesn't want you to battle that. No, don't waste your time fighting a fight that's not for you. It's not your battle. It's the Lord's. Y'all hear me? Whoo, Lord Jesus. Okay, when you pray, God listens. When you pray, God listens. Watch this. Even when you don't see him, you can be comforted knowing that God always has your best interest at heart. I repeat, God always has our best interests at heart. When you feel alone, he is there waiting for you to call on him. Through prayer and through thanksgiving, you need to tell God how you feel and ask him for what you need. Some of y'all don't even open up your mouths to ask God. You think you got to do the thuses and the thous and this and that and the other. God don't care nothing about the King's English. What is wrong with y'all? You ain't got to be so stuck and traditional that you got to read the King James. That's the King James version. Get the gist of what the man is saying from the old English and just say, God, I need your help. Help me. Good Lord. That's a simple ask. Some of y'all so bold and full of pride, you don't even know how to ask God for help. Because you think you're going to fix it. You can't fix nothing without God. Come on now. Let's just keep it real. We just really some dumb heap of flesh. That's all we really are. The wisdom comes from God, not from you, not from the world. The world is done. God got it wrapped up. They think they got it going on with all this AI stuff, technology. God, come on now. You shut it down. All electricity go away. Boop. Can't do nothing with AI then, can you? I mean, let's just keep it real. Let's not get stupid, right? Let's just know that we're on the right side and that God is on our side. And no matter how big the mountain, we can move it by faith. Come on, y'all. God had to remind me, ain't nothing he can't fix in my life. Ooh, nothing. Come on now. Like I said, you got to do this. You through praying through Thanksgiving. Tell God how you feel and ask him for what you need. Watch. And I'm going to show you where that's in the scriptures. Go to Philippians 4, 6, and 7. The NIV version says this. It says, do not be anxious about anything. Omicron, the flu, common cold, cancer, AIDS. I'm just giving you diseases. Syphilis, whatever, gonorrhea, whatever, HIV, whatever. He said, don't be anxious about anything. Divorce, unemployment, the wrong president getting voted in, your team losing. Don't be anxious about anything. You not having a chance to preach at Lake Wind. So what? Don't be anxious about anything, he said. He said, but in every situation. Notice, what's every, everybody? What's every? He said, in every situation, good or bad, every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. How simple can that be? He said, present your request. What do you want? God said, what do you want, Derek? Tell me what you want, son. Come Thanksgiving. Thank me for giving. I'm going to take care. Already come in with a heart of Thanksgiving, knowing that I love you. I got you. You're in right standing. You're doing all the right things, my brother. You got Jesus. You're covered in the blood. Come on in here, brother. Ask me what you want and watch me work. Watch me work on your behalf. I want to do it. Won't he do it? He said he would. Ooh, he going to do it. Won't he do it? Let me tell you, he will do it. But you got to do it according to his word, y'all. Come on now. It says, and the peace of God. Watch this. Verse 7 says, and the peace of God which transcends all understanding. Now, that's powerful. Because, see, we too busy trying to figure it all out. The devil's in the details. God didn't tell you to worry about the details. He just said right there, and the peace of God which transcends all understanding. He ain't got time for you to figure it out. He just said, ask me and I'll take care of it, Derek, and you can figure it out later. You'll get it somewhere in the by and by. But in the meantime, you need healing. In the meantime, you need deliverance. In the meantime, you need to get up and go get a job in the meantime, because it's waiting on you to go get it. Come on now. You got to get up. I got you. God said, I'm on your side, brother. I got your back. Make a move. Stop being negative. Stop talking negative. Start being positive. It's going to close. Everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to work. You good. Don't listen to them negative folk because they got their act all messed up. Don't let them mess up your life. Don't let them fools talk to you because a fool and their money should soon part. You get with a fool, you're going to lose your money too. So just leave them alone. Go on and get with God. Get in your secret place. Pray, ask, and thanks. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you say. Hey, I receive it in the name of Jesus, Lord. Get on up and excited about what's about to happen in your life. Why are you listening to CNN? CNN don't know you. CNN don't know your God. So why are you listening to CNN or NNN? Why are you listening to them? Them Negroes don't know nothing. They don't know about you. They don't know what you done been through with the Lord. They don't know the victories you've had with the Lord. So why are you trying to convince folk that don't need to be convinced because they don't care nothing about the Lord? So keep it moving. Keep it moving. Dust your feet. Keep it moving. Because God's going to show out in your life. Won't he do it? Yes, he will. Whoo! Man! Y'all better hear me tonight. Your Heavenly Father loves you. I'll say it again. Our Heavenly Father loves us. God loves us. He is love. He can't do nothing but love you, especially when you made the decision to join the family. You got all the love you can handle right now, but you can't block it through your ignorance of listening to the world or listening to man who does not know him. Watch it. Be careful what you're letting in your ear gate. Be careful what you're saying with your mouth gate. And be careful what you're putting in the eye gate. You got to surround yourself with all of the positive things God wants you to know, to experience, and for you to have right now in the here and now and not in the thereafter. Granted, I know you want to go to heaven, some of y'all. I get it. But you're here. You're here. So heaven can wait. There was a movie called Heaven Can Wait. Heaven waiting on you, but you got some things to do here by faith, not in heaven. God gave you faith for now. It said now faith, not thereafter faith. You got to prove your faith here and now in the living, the land of the living. You can't please God with faith in heaven. You're already there. There's no need for faith in heaven. Think about it now. You ain't seen no word that said you're going to need faith in heaven. God gave us a measure of faith for here and now. And you got to show you can use it, do it, and make it work right now. Whew, I know that hit home, didn't it? Good God. So your Heavenly Father loves you, and He is always ready to answer when you call Him. Your Heavenly Father loves you. Some of us got major love issues. I'm telling you, trust me, some of y'all don't even love yourselves. I'm sorry, it's just true. You look in the mirror, you probably look away. You don't want to look at yourself. You got all these issues going on. You can't accept the fact that God made you the way that you are. You got to accept the fact that God made me with a big head, big old nose, and a gap in my teeth. It is what it is. But I've learned that God made me that way, and I just got to love it. I got to accept it for what it is and keep it moving. Because I know God loves me, and God's going to take care of me. And I got to learn to love myself. Got to learn to love yourself. Because if you don't, you're going to get kicked around like a tin can on a hard street. People will abuse those who abuse themselves. Stop abusing yourself with a lack of love of self. And I mean a good love. I'm not talking about a selfish love. I'm talking about a respect for the creation that God has made, keeping the temple strong, keeping it holy as God told you to. Love it because God is dwelling in it. The love of God. God is love is in you. The power of God is in you. The power of love is in you. Use it to your advantage, not to your disadvantage. God said, I love you. Go to Jeremiah 33:3. Let me show you. The New International Version in Jeremiah 33:3 says this. Call to me and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. He's always ready to answer you if you call on him. Call on him. Call him up. I hear that song now. Ha! If you confess the Lord, call him up. Hey! If you confess the Lord, call him up. If you believe in the power and the Holy Ghost, call him up and tell him what you are. Y'all remember that one? Woo! Woo! We used to get fire on that one, boy. But you got to call him up because he will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. That's why you don't have to understand. God's going to tell you. He's going to reveal it to you. He gonna show you exactly what you need to know in the time when you're supposed to know it. It's gonna be all right. That's why you can trust him. God has your back, and he wants you to believe he will keep his word concerning you. God is gonna keep his word. He's not a liar. That's another thing y'all got to get in your spirit. When God said it, it is done. It is so. Ain't no backing off of it. God's not backing off his word. His word is truth. Truth can't turn to no lie. It's pure. It's real. It's God. And God said, I ain't turning back. If I said I'm going to deliver you, I'm going to deliver you. Come on now. God said, if I love you, I love you. I ain't trying to change. You the one changing. God says, I change not. Y'all little roaches running around changing all every 5 minutes because you ain't locked in on the truth. You haven't locked in on the word because you out here thinking the world's going to do you right, but it ain't. It ain't going to do you right. The world is a trip. But God's word is not. It's not a trip. God's word is truth. Amen? Amen. All right. Now, a word of caution here. God is on the side of the righteous. Let me clarify. I know I'm getting excited. I get excited. Forgive me. But I want y'all to get this. Excuse me. Ooh. Lord Jesus. I repeat, a word of caution. God is on the side of the righteous, those in right standing with him, because of accepting the sacrifice of Jesus. See, those born again, those who accepted Jesus Christ, they're in right standing because Jesus gave you his righteousness. Once you believe and receive, you have his righteousness. That's whose side he's on, the believer's side. See, unbelievers, they don't have what we have. It's an exclusive situation. It's called members only. You remember members only used to be a members only jacket back in the day? I know I'm telling my age. Members only used to be a designer, and you had a little members only jacket. You had something real special. Members only, everybody. God is on the side of those who are the member of the Christ Jesus family. If you're a member of the family, he's on your side. He's going to fight your battles. He's going to take care of you. You win. You good. You got it. You're great. Move on. And so those of us who haven't made that decision, then guess what? He's calling you to come and join the family so he can execute his word in your life. But if you're not in, you're out. It's real simple. You need to get in, get in, get in, get in, get in. Let me show you. It says God is on the side of truth. His word is truth, right? Go to John 17 and 17. John 17 and 17 says this. I'm reading the New Living Translation, NLT, New Living Translation. It says this, make them holy by your truth. Teach them your word, which is truth. That's what we do, y'all. Lakeland, that's what we do. I just give you what God is saying. It's real simple. It's real. I keep it plain like Jesus. We ain't got to get all caught up in the hermeneutics and all this and PhD and this, that, and that. Look, the word, God want to make sure everybody gets this word from the hood to Buckhead, Bankhead to Buckhead. He ain't trying to get you all caught up in the intellectual. I get it. But when it's plain and simple, truth is truth. And you got to lock into it. That's in now. God is on our side when we are on his side. Additionally, just because God is on our side, watch this, does not mean that we are always guaranteed immediate success, nor that we are spared hard times or trouble. In other words, we ain't in this pie in the sky mentality. We got to go through some things, right? Prove it. Here's the word. John 16 and 33. The NLT, New Living Translation, says this. I have told you all this. I've told you all this so that you may have peace in me. Here on earth, you will have many trials and sorrows, but take heart because I have overcome the world. So in other words, we all going through something, but man, we got faith to get through it. And then Jesus said, don't worry about it. I got this. The world is mine. I'm taking it over. We're getting ready to make it happen. It's all good. Jesus said, I got it. Take heart. I got it. Don't be fearful of what's going on in the government. Don't be fearful of what's going on in science. Hey, don't be fearful of what's going on in these foreign countries and wars and famine and all. Jesus said, I got that. The time is coming in a real quick second. Before you know it, I'm here handling my business. And where will you be is the question. Will you be on his side or the other side? You got to get it right now. Amen, amen, amen. Now, here's some scriptures about the Lord is on my side, and we're going to close out with a bunch of scriptures. Let's give it a run. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Here comes the word. All right. Scriptures about the Lord is on my side. Here's the first one. Number one, God is on my side. Watch this. I will not fear. See, when you get a revelation that God is on your side, ain't nothing you need to be afraid of. Nothing, nothing. He says, I will not fear. Go to Psalm 118 and 6. Psalm 118 and 6 says this. In the English Standard Version, the Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me? Wow. Whew. What can man do to me? What can man do to me? That's bold, isn't it? Let that sink in. The Lord is on my side. I ain't gonna fear nothing. I ain't fearing nobody. What can man do to me? He can try. But if God has a mission in your life, if God has a purpose for you, do you know it's going to get done and accomplished no matter what man says or does or tries to do to stop you? When God is on your side, your mission will be accomplished in him. Amen. Come on now. Number two, God is on our side. We can trust him. Go to Psalm 118 and 8. The King James Version says this. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Y'all better hear me. It is better to trust the Lord than to put confidence in man. Number three, God is on my side to help me. Satan, the enemy of my soul, is defeated. Go to Psalm 118 and 7. The English Standard Version says this. The Lord is on my side as my helper. I shall look in triumph on those who hate me. Whoa! Whoa! Let me say that again. The Lord is on my side as my helper. I shall look in triumph on those who hate me. So if you got some haters, and we all do, and God is on your side, you're winning. They're not. It is what it is. You can't get away from it. Praise God. Number four, God will never forsake you. God will never forsake you. Go to Hebrews 13 and 5. The English Standard Version says this. Keep your life free from the love of money. I know that hurt some of y'all. That's called an obligatory pause. Woo! Keep your life free from the love of money. Why? Because the love of money is the root of all evil. The love of money and not of God is the root of all evil. And be content with what you have. Whoo! Stop trying to keep up with the Joneses. He said, be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. God is not measuring you based on your wealth. He says, I'm with you in your poverty, in your strife, in your challenges, and I'm with you when you're going through blessings, when you're prospering, when you're doing well and you're healthy and everything's great. He says, I'm not leaving you in any situation. I will not forsake you. I will always be there to help you, because even rich people got rich problems. I'll say it again. Even rich people have rich problems and still need God. Still need God. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Number five, keep your confident trust in God. Keep your confident trust in God. Mike Riley, what's happening, bro? I see you, man. Welcome, man. Golly, good to see you, brother. Keep your confident trust in God. Hebrews 13 and 6. Hebrews 13 and 6, the English Standard Version says, so we can confidently say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear. See, when you understand that God is on your side, he's here to help you, you can't be afraid. You got to always keep the positive outlook on that positive outcome. That if God said it, so it is. If you're going to be healed, you're healed. I mean, once God sees you're locked in, he already set the universe to respond to your faith and make it happen. He's the creator of the universe, the elements, the protons, the electrons, everything that you can't see, the invisible, he's in it. And so there's some vibes that come out of us. It's our spirit that emanates and starts moving things either in the right direction or the wrong direction. He says the issues of life come from our heart, meaning from our conscious, our thinking, what we think, what we're thinking. If we're thinking negative, then guess what? You're going to bring on the negative. It's not going to change and go opposite of that. God didn't create the world to be that way. He wants you to understand when you put the word of God out, you're going to get the word, the positive effect of the word back. And so start using it in that way. Use it to change your life for the better, because God's word is better than your word. Come on, y'all. Number six. Yes, God is on our side to help us. Yes, God is on our side to help us. Satan, the enemy of our souls, once again, is defeated. Go to Psalm 108 and 13. The Good News Translation says it this way. With God on our side, we will win. He will defeat our enemies. Oh, woo! With God on our side, we will win, Lake Win, Lake Win, Lake Win. We will win when God is on our side. Yes, sometimes blessings can be delayed, but God is delaying them for a reason. You're not ready for it yet. He knows you're going to get it. You're going to get it, but God knows the right timing to release it in your life so it won't be destructive blessing. It'll be an awesome blessing that you get to another level where you can be a blessing. See, you got to realize that some of us are missing the blessing because we're not prepared to receive it. That's another sermon for another day. Ooh, how to receive from God. I will preach that word. That's going to be powerful. Now watch this. Number 7. This I know, God is on my side. This I know, God is on my side. Go to Psalm 56 and 9, and it's going to be the New Living Translation, just a portion of the scripture. It says, this I know, God is on my side. You got to know that God is on your side. See, the psalmist David, he knew when he was going to battle. He knew when he was being challenged. He knew when his son was going to war against him to kill him. He knew when he did what he did wrong. He still knew that God is on my side. God loved David because David never lost thought of the fact that God was on his side and that he was going to help him in every circumstance and situation. Read then, King, see what happened when David and all the enemy came and took all the women and children from the village, and they came back from wherever they were fighting, and everyone was gone. And the whole army turned against David and said, because of you, David, we've lost our families. They're gone. And David had to go and separate himself from the negative soldiers that were ready to kill him, that were hating him, because they felt it was his fault that the women and children were stolen and all their riches and all their belongings. David said, no, I'm going to God, went to God. God helped me. God told him where to find those folks. Said, y'all come with me. Told them soldiers, come on. I know where they're at. Went over there, got the women and children back, and took all of the goods back plus some, because he knew God was on his side. No matter how detrimental the circumstance may be, ladies and gentlemen, I don't care how bad you say it is. When God says it's right and good, it'll change. When you use the word of God, it changes things. It reverses the negative. It reverses the disease. It reverses blindness to sight. It reverses lameness to being able to walk and run. It reverses sickness to health. It reverses poverty to wealth. It reverses all the negative to the positive. But don't let the devil deceive you and tell you the lie that you're not supposed to have the goodness of God in your life. That's a lie from the pit of hell. You better know that God is on your side. This I know. God is on my side. Woo! Number 8. I love this one. Number 8 says, if God is for us, who can be against us? Y'all better read it. Romans 8 and 31. The English Standard Version says, what then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? Whoo! If he's on your side, you're going to win. You're going to win. Some of you all need to hear this. Some of you all are going through. I can feel it. I feel it. I feel it. Some of you all were about to give up. You just got really depressed. You got quiet. You got put down. You sat down. You couldn't enjoy yourself. Things, because usually holidays can bring a lot of nonsense to people in their homes. I know it. It ain't always cookies and cream. I mean, it could be really challenging. Some of us didn't have family, didn't have food. Nobody cared. Nobody called. Nobody brought you nothing. Let me tell you something. Devil is a lie. You get the truth of God's word about how Jesus came back to give you life and give you life more abundantly. You need to get the word of God in your spirit, and you need to meditate on that thing, on the positive word, and let it change your circumstance. Stop worrying about what people are saying about you. Stop worrying about what people are trying to do to you. You better worry about what God is trying to do to you. You better wake up to what God is trying to say to you. You need to hear from the Lord. You need a word from God, like right now, that tells you you are winning because God is on your side. You will have the victory. God is on your side. There's nothing God can't, nothing too hard for God. Nothing impossible for God. He loves impossibilities because he is the possible God that will make it happen for you. Woo! He wants to fight that battle. He wants you to be victorious. He wants you to win at the end of the day. God bless you. Woo! Number 9. Always rely on God for strength and help. Always rely on God for strength and help. Isaiah 41 and 10, the New International Version says this: "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Go ahead, God. Number 10, never forget God is with us always. Never forget it. Go to Matthew 28 and 20. The New International Version says this: "And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age." God said, "I ain't leaving you. I got to escort you from this realm into the spiritual realm. I'm going to be with you through eternity. I ain't going nowhere." God said, "I ain't going nowhere. I got you." You know, somebody say, "I got you, bro. I got you. I got you." God is saying, "I got you. I got you. Go on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Go on." He said, "Come on. Talk to me. Talk to me. Talk to me now. Come on. Let's talk. Let's talk. Let's talk. Let's talk. Let's get this thing right. Let's get it together." God said, "Come on now. I'm here with you to the end, brother. All the way to the end. I ain't going nowhere." God said, "I ain't going nowhere. If anybody's going to move, it's going to be you that moves out of position of blessing. Remember, we block our blessings. God doesn't block the blessing. The blessings are coming constantly. Jesus took care of that. It's coming nonstop. But you got to be in a position to catch it, because you got to get your mind right to know that God wants you to have it and not let the devil tell you the lie that he says he don't want you to have it. God loves us. He's love. Amen. I'm going to do the invitation to salvation right now. I just think that it's important that we do this for those of you who need to be born again to enter into this family of believers so that you can take advantage of God being on your side. It's very simple. I just read from Romans 10 and 9 right now. And you just repeat after me. Lord, I shall confess with thy mouth that the Lord Jesus, that Jesus is Lord, and shall believe in my heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, thou shalt be saved. It's real simple. And then, for with the heart man believeth, right, unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So you have to confess it with your mouth. You have to say it. You have to let people hear it. You got to let God hear it. And it's got to come from your heart. It's got to come from your mind. You got to believe it. You got to believe these things, that Jesus Christ did die. Some people want to tell you that he didn't die. He was a prophet and all this kind of stuff. All these lies about Jesus. Jesus died. And then God raised him from the dead after the third day. And that he is the Messiah. Okay? He is our Messiah. He is our Savior. He is Jesus Lord, our Savior. And you got to believe it. Because if you don't believe it, none of this works. It doesn't work. It's not going to work. But God bless you. Repeat after me. Father God, I repent of my sins against you. I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Save me, Lord. If you save me, I will commit my life to live for you forever. Fill me with the Holy Ghost that I might live according to the way you would have me to live. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. All right, it's time to give, 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 give. All right, there it is. Thank you, Pastor K. That's where you can give, give, give. I'm going to do Givelify right here. I'm going to do Givelify. I like Givelify. Thank you, Pastor K, for giving me that. It makes it real simple. You guys need to download the app. But I'm going to go ahead and give right now, right now. Here we go. Lakewind Christian Center. It says give. I hit give. Watch this. I hit the amount I want to give. And there it is. And there it is. And watch this. How easy it is. Success. Booyah. Success. There it is. There it is. I did it. It's in. Amen. Amen. So y'all need to give, man. We got to put money back into our ministry so we can keep doing this good work that God has blessed us with. We got to show you. Hey, I also want to tell you, look, we all need to get in oneness. This is first Sunday coming up. And I do a special invitation. I want the mother's board, deacon's board, praise team, everybody. We got to show up this first Sunday so we can break bread and give God honor and get a part, be a part of this sacrament that's very important in our lives as believers, that we recognize the Lord's Supper and the importance of it. But it's so awesome when we all come together. Bring your family, bring your friends. Come on out, y'all. This is First Sunday. This is the end of the year. We need to start getting ready for 2022. We need to come together and start planning for what we're going to do as a ministry to help people in the community and make a difference in the lives of others. But we got to get in oneness. It's so important to get into oneness right now. And we got a new year coming up. Man, 2022 is going to be awesome. I just know it is for a lot of us. And we're going to bring in Night Watch, and we want you to be there. We're going to have a special guest speaker. Another pastor's coming to speak to us, praise God, and bring his church. We're going to have a great time. We want all of Lakeland to be there to be hospitable and welcome those folks into our ministry that want to be a part of what we're doing on Night Watch service. And so, my God, come on out, y'all. Come on back. Come on back. First Sunday, let's do it. Let's break bread together. And ministers, elders, all of you all, please join us. Mike Riley says, I want to give. That's right, Mike. You got to sow that seed, brother. But hey, love y'all, man. God bless you. You got Sunday service, First Sunday, midweek service next Wednesday. And hey, it's awesome. I hope y'all loved it. Everywhere was great. I saw a lot of love and thumbs up. And man, I told you it's going to be good. God is on our side. Whew. I love y'all. See y'all Sunday. Be a blessing to others. Go Georgia. Go Dawgs. Amen. Y'all have a good one. Bye-bye.